I always wanted to do something that would help others. And I feel like teaching is one of those occupations, and there's many of them in the world. But I was born the oldest of 11. And so from my very earliest time that I can remember, I was teaching. I was helping somebody in the family do something. And so I think it just came naturally to me, and it's all I've known. And so I'll just keep doing it because I get a great payback from it every day.
So we have $48 that we spent for six tickets. Maybe we went to see the Minnesota Twins.
I have always loved teaching math.
You all understood the ratio part of it, but it was the batting average that was kind of sticky for you. So
probably the reason is, as a kid, that was the hardest subject for me. I found that most difficult. I loved to read as a student, but I had troubles problem solving. And I'd get frustrated because people would be helpful in giving me the answer, but they wouldn't be helpful in helping me solve the problem. And so I saw a real need for that when I trained to be a teacher.
So how much does each egg cost, class? 10 cents.
I try to help them understand that what we're learning now, they're going to need later on, and try to apply that to their daily life or what will be their adult life.
My husband drives a truck, and he gets 14 miles to the gallon. Let's see how far he can go in his truck on one tank of gas.
She does a really good job at explaining, and she puts the lessons we're learning into our daily lives, like figuring out 70s, if you could buy 8 eggs for 76 cents or 12 eggs for $1.08. And then we'd have to figure this out in a store, and she puts that into our daily lives.
Every ounce of laundry detergent you use, you're gonna save a penny, aren't you?
She makes it more fun because it's funny and stuff. She like points out people and pretends they're the person. Like it was a real estate problem about money and stuff. And she was like giving people the titles of the story problems. It was pretty fun.
And you're telling your wife, you know what? If I don't have some clean underwear tomorrow, I'm not gonna be able to go to work.
I'm always the first one to make fun of myself first. You know, I'm the short, chubby old woman, and so I'm good material. And if they see I'm doing that, then they have fun with it and they don't feel bad when I always tell them, if I'm picking on you, it means I like you because we're just having fun together. We're learning together.
Should I buy the 64 ounces? I mean, we do have a lot of laundry. Or should I go 96 and work on my biceps? Carry something heavy home.
Not only do I want them to be able to do math and to problem solve, but I want them to be able to communicate with other students. So every day we try to do some work with another student, especially in this day and age with social media. Kids are not always prepared to practice their social skills and to communicate with other people. So I want them to be good communicators. I want them to learn to be good listeners. I want them to be good citizens, and I want them to be responsible for their own learning.
We're finding unit rates.
I was so honored when I was selected here in our district. I just feel really humbled that I would be chosen. And I had no idea that this award is involving me in policy in South Dakota. I'm learning a lot that way. It's giving me an opportunity to share ideas and to speak with other people in the state, which, I mean, I love teaching. I love my work here. And this has just opened up a whole new world for me that I wasn't expecting. What keeps me teaching is I get a lot of payback, a lot of reward from working with kids. They are our most important resource in South Dakota.